satellite. So Amitabh, his voice also. Okay. IPR and copyright basically quoting the medical references from journals and the books. Most of the times, if you see such type of quotes, copyrights reserved. That means that material, that literature, that book or trail is copyrighted, and they write, don't use, reprint, reproduce or without prior permission. That means it is legally copyrighted. Avoid production likely cause to. So there are some case studies on this copyright. Copyright violations could lead to criminal or the civil suits, could lead to. So be aware of the web domain thing. So don't try to steal somebody's material and put it on go for the copywriting. Use of internet for selling and downloading from internet except for the personal use must always honors IPRs. So recent copyright cases is Chetan Bhatti edit is a very well known case study. October 10 clear that Saregamapa has the right to grant the license. Then April 10 Kolkata High Court restrained the use of the Apni to ICIC from Lavaris in the movie Houseful. So there are so many thing cases on the copyright if you read the literature. And degree of protection, basically what is copyright and what is patent? Copyright DRC. You want to express any ideas that can go for the copyright, speak, and its protection scope is fairly narrow. Basically, copywriting very narrow protection. And for patent, you get the art protection inclusive the equivalence. Like the novel idea itself when applied can cover a relatively broader scope including various applications. So harmonical design act basically of the copyright, shape, size, color, etc. They are covered in the US. You can see such marks. They are covered under the copyright. Okay. And for examples, you can see they are covered under the copyright. What is a geography? Okay, it is basically an indication. It originates geographical territory. Like you must have heard about the Basmati. Okay, this is a great example of the geographical indication. Okay, used to identify agricultural, natural, all the manufacturing goods. Similar to the Kolhapuri chappal. Okay, the manufactured goods should be produced or prepared in that territory only. It should have quality or reputation or other characteristics. Each material quality or a reputation or different characteristics. What is covered? GI of goods are defined as that aspect to which geographical indication refers to a country or therein as being the country and the place of the origin. Basically, TRIPS part 2. Of the World Trade Organization enacted the geographical indication of 1999 has come into force with effect from 15 October 2003. Geographical indication of goods and registration act came in 9 and registration in rules. So these are some of the examples of the geographical basmati rice is a well-known example of geographical indication. Then Darjeeling tea, Anchipuram silk, then Alfonso mango, then Nagpur orange, Kolhapuri chappal, then Bikaneri bhujia, Agra petha, penny, Palkanram patta, then Newara rice. So many examples of the geographical indication. I have covered a few of them for illustration. And this is a very important geographical indication. Most of the times people, they visit the Tirupati laddu with take that laddu and all the process is now for manufacturing patent geographical indication coming under the geographical indication. October 10 rectification petition filed in geographical industry registry. In 2010 Madras High Court dismissed the petition on the ground that alternate remedy for rectification under the GI Act has not been exhausted. So this is the story of how we got the geographical indication Tirupati laddu. What is trade secret? What is covered in Trade secret basically is nothing but a formula, a practice, a design, instrument, pattern or compilation of information which is not generally known or reasonably ascertable by which a business can obtain an economic advantage over the competitors. Okay, in some jurisdictions, such secrets are referred to as confidential information. Most of the times we write below, suppose I am writing their confidential information. That means this is coming under the, or the classified information. Trade secret, again, it is a formula for a sport drink, survey method, professional posters, or some recipes in for which a patent application has not yet been filed, that you can go for mark trade secret. Then marketing strategy, manufacturing techniques, and computer algorithm. You must have seen the bottles which we use for drinking, okay, different drinks. So these bottles under the trade secret, the formula is a trade secret. What is the requirement for trade secret? Basically the secrecy. There should be some involved into this. So basically formula for Coca-Cola, the sauce, KFC chicken recipe, or WD-40. Okay, these are coming under the trade secrets. And this is very important. If you want to see that what is basically the intellectual property, shown here one product. Basically, it is a inhaler developed by the Cipla. Okay, you can see this, and they got the patent. This patent number, based on their novel and the inventive steps. Okay, what is this is basically trademark is a multi-haler. This is covered. Okay. Then design is covered under this number for this inhaler. And trade secret know-how, again, it is covered. Full inhaler and copyright is granted. Package, insulation leaflet, how it is packed, what type of packaging they are doing, what type of design. So you can understand what is patent, what is trademark, what is trade secret and what is copyright. In one example, illustrate everything. Then I will come to now the idea how it was evolved. Basically, evolution is like this: 1970, 72, 23 years, then 1995 we took, and then from 2005. So basically from GATT, WTO, TRIPS and the IP, this is basically the evolvement of the products patents in it was before. You can see that how it is in a another way. Sources, there are incremental innovations, then need-based solutions, then intensive research, disruptive innovation, and serendipity. So basically it is evolved. Here, 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 and then we came here. In the other way, if you can see that comparatively from here to here going, this is the earlier thing, even Indian patents 96 doing thing. Then I will come now the part two of what is patent, what is patent procedure. So this will be the content, what is patent, what is not patentable, or how to write the specification draft, specification contents, how to write the claim, especially the first claim, interpret, and what are the examination practices, and what is peace Budapest Treaty. What is the intellectual property? Patent is a form of intellectual property, which is the creation of the human mind that is protected by a law in a fashion to the real property. Like we protect our real property, like the flat, plot, some land. Similarly, you protect your intellectual property in the form. So patent is a limited monopoly. Basically, it gives a limited monopoly, a right conferred by the country in consideration of the invention. Okay. This is the correct definition of the patent, a property right government to an inventor to exclude others from making, offering for sale or selling the invention or for a limited time in exchange of public disclosure of the invention when the patent is granted. Basically, I even for today, in today, there are a lot of patents on mine, but I'm not going for any production. But what others from making, using, or offering sale or selling the invention. If they want to take my idea, they want to take my patent, they have to pay me some royalty. Okay, that is the advantage. Okay. Necessary is that if I am filing a patent so that I should go for the production. That is okay. I will block others. Okay. What is the misconception? Basically, the patents inhibit the free exchange of information. Basically, it is a legal document issued by the patent office, granted for a limited period. Each patent has a time that the patent gets expired and the knowledge becomes open. Then geographical limit of the country. It depends again the geographical limit of the country. A right to exclude others. Okay, basically, how to exclude others from making or selling. Grant. Balance of rights and obligations subject to other land, then grant of owner of invention and the assignee. A patent is perform the invention or a monopoly in the marketplace. Difference between this patent is not a right to perform the invention or a monopoly. Why it is required IP protection? For the progress of technology. Suppose I want to make some product and bring into the market. Your own patent, you should have your own intellectual property. Then only you can go for the progress of technology, for the progress of the field of technology, okay? For encouraging inventive and feel secure and contribute content. Basically in India that if you work abroad, I work abroad with General Electric Corporation, filing a patent. Once you file a patent, then you will get US dollar into your account that just they give the manager award. Type of incentives are given in the foreign countries for filing the patent, but incentive criteria is not there in India. Okay, that is the incentive given to any person who has filed a patent in that money is given as an award for an inventive creative mind and to feel secure and to contribute. To convert intellectual capabilities and its outcome in the form of a product. That's why the IP protection is required to contribute for the progress and society. So basically, why patent is patenting is a prestigious. Today I say that so many patents. So I did it. I was the first. Like this, the question mind, and it will be a prestigious thing for any individual, any or any institute. And easy publication, basically there are no editors. If you want to publish a paper in high impact journal, there will be three editors. Then you have to wait. Okay. In patent also, there are who will examine your patent, but not like the publications. Once I file a patent, got the patent on my name, issued to institute or issued to my company, then there are licensing possibilities. What I will do, even though I have filed patent, I will not go for production, but I will sell my knowledge to the companies who are interested. And in that process, the royalties, okay? Whatever the money I have recouped while doing this research in R&D and expand collaborations. So if people outside India, they see the patents are your name in which area you are working, then there are expanded collaborations. People will and ask you for the collaborations like this. We brought so at the CSIR NCL. Okay, during our time when there was a money hunch for doing the research, then commercial and other competitors. There are again so many commercial advantages over the provide valuable trading asset to help assure freedom to operate. Another thing which is important. That's why you should have your own patent. patent right, most of the times we don't understand what is the right of a patent. A patent by the government that entitles the owner to exclude from making, using, selling, offering to sell or import any in the country in a patented invention. A domestic patent only provides this in the country. A patent does not necessarily give the owner the right to practice because the other's potential prior patent rights. And I'll be proud that in India, whoever files the first patent or the, goes to him. So whoever files the first, basically, if you see the structure of IP office in India, most of you, where are the offices located? Okay, how to file a patent? What is the filing the patent? How to register a patent? Controller of patents, a designer for CGPDM, and there are patent offices, Kolkata, Delhi, Mumbai. Then in Kolkata, design office is in Kolkata. Then yeah, this is another office in Nagpur. The TM registry head office, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, and Aurangabad. Then GI registry and Chennai. So how the an overview, controller general, below this joint controller, deputy controller, and controller, and then there are examiners who are qualified in the in the highly qualified people. They examine whatever you are filing. What is an invention? Most of the times I was telling that we are most of the time invention and innovation. What is invention means? Any new, useful art, process, method, or manner of manufacture, machine, apparatus, or other article, substance produced by manufacturer and include and useful implement of any of them and invention. But what is the new new definition of invention? Invention means a new product or process having an inventive step and capable of industrial application. Invention should have go to the new product or a process. Could be some inventive steps which are critical and capable of industry. So according to this section, this invent new product or a process involving an inventive step of industrial production. What is patentable? Anything under the sun that is patentable, that is a definition given by the Chakravarti in 80. But you can see that what is patentable, which gives invention, then application, satisfy the conditions. Always keep in mind that what is patentable. Invention must relate to a process or product, must be new or a novel, it should involve step, be capable of industrial application and not fall under. What is new means, most of the time, what is new? Invention must be published in India or in prior public, must not be published in India or elsewhere, in prior public knowledge or public this thing, claim. If you want to publish, once you publish or give some talk or submit an abstract, that material you cannot patent it because that's information. What is inventive step? Most of the time, what is basically the inventive step? The feature of an invention that is technical advantage as compared to the existing knowledge. Technical advantage of the invention which I have done, okay? Over knowledge, or does it have any economic significance and makes the invention not obvious to a person skill? Obvious, then you cannot go for patenting. It should be non-obvious. This is a very important slide. What is the requirability? Useful, novel, and non-obvious. Must have some utility, achieve some objective. The public policy. Novel means must be new, prior art. Prior art means whatever already people they have already or taken publisher. Okay. And what is non-obvious? Subject matter as a whole, have been obvious at the time of person of this ordinary skills. So before drafting, you must see that what is the invention? Invention patentable. Is invention novel? Is there an inventive step? What is the prior art? What is oral disclosure? Prior information available to the public and prior public use. Before drafting, you should go through these steps. Conduct the literature search. The literature search, not from Google. You have to use some paid search engines like, which will give the exhaustive search material, but Google will give only the limited. SciFinder is again from the society which covers each and everything till the last minute. What is patents are there? How many published literature is there? How many conference proceedings are? Conduct the literature search by using the proper search engine. Enlist the problems in the prior art. If you are using the SciFinder, then I want to use the option called Panorama. Panorama will plot X and Y axis. Where are the gaps available? And you can focus those areas for your research so that you can get some new ideas, new thinking, file some patents in that area. Then what is the problem sought to be solved? If I am filing or working on this problem, basically, what solve the problems? And what is the novelty of my work? Is the solution obvious? Is it artificially excluded? Publication ensued. Again, you have to see that, is there any public literature? Ascertain the type of application, whether complete or the provisional. Initially, first you have to file the provisional case and then it goes for the complete filing. Decide and the nature of protection, where you want to go, Paris Convention, PCT, ordinary application. Then what is not patentable? List, frivolous inventions, they are not patentable. Well established natural laws, you cannot patent it. Contrary to morality or injurious to public health, like animal, plants, and that you cannot patent it. Scientific principle or abstract theory that you can. New property or use of a known substance, that also you cannot patent it. Add mixtures as opposed in synergistic mixtures and the process that you cannot patent it. Or mere arrangement or rearrangement of the known devices, each functioning independently. So this is a big list which okay, it's continuous. Method of agriculture, horticulture, treatment, animal including diagnostic methods, plants and animals in whole, then essentially biological processes, mathematical business methods, literary, artistic, musical thing, then method of playing games, information. Now you must understand in the public domain knowledge and what is common general knowledge. Known to persons is part of the mental equipment of those concerned in the art under this. This is really according to the patentability. This is what is the public knowledge? What is the common all available public knowledge and all that is published? That is a common general knowledge. And this is a public knowledge. So kinds of publications again down. Papers or publications should provide unmistakable direction disclosure of the invention. Even single disclosure is sufficient. Extent of publication available. So who reads this patent specifications? Patent office, licensing or assignee, court, the technique, or the skilled persons, or the competitors who are working in that area, commercial players who are going for such type of products, and the general public. So again, I will come to the patent filing. So go for the patent specification. Again, there are two types of specification, right? First, it will be provisional patent and then it will be complete specification. Okay, then kinds of applications. Again, conventional, Paris or PCT, non-conventional, divisional, patent of addition. Since we are citizen of India, first we have to file the Indian patent. Is filed. Then if you want to go for the PCT, then go for the PCT application. Once you file the PCT application, then you can cover 146 countries window application. What are the pros and cons application when there is an urgency? Suppose I want to submit a thesis, submit a paper to some journal. okay, then there is a need to the provisional patent filing or any commercial disclosure. Audit is the for developing that product and we are in a hurry. Submission of want to submit the thesis, so before submission of or before disclosing that knowledge, business specification, or any inventor leaving the company, a person, but he is leaving the organization. So before he leaves, file the provisional application. Any accidental disclosure, I was doing something but I got something. It was an accidental disclosure, and there are some points to be. So in such cases, file the provisional. Or there are many competitors. Yes, immediately you file the provisional specification. What is the provisional specification? Basically, is a document describing the invention and need not contain any claims. Disclose as much as possible. Okay, decide the date of application. For deciding the date on which you have filed the provisional specification, you have to write. You have to fill the form too. So there are different forms you have to fill. Patent, the following specification describes the invention. Okay, a provisional again can be amended. You can add, delete, or new at the time of filing, but to be completed within 12 months. If dating maximum 6 months will be given to you to complete those in. Then a complete specification basically is a technological describing and specifically claiming the invention. So form two. Specification particularly describes and ascertains the nature. Such type of wording you have to use in the form two, invention manner in which it is performed. Then patent specification, it contains description and the claims. So claim is the heart of the patent, especially the first claim. So I will come to that. What is description? Description discusses the invention. You describe the invention in detail. Okay. Claims define boundary of the. So basically, claims are written in a legal manner, and it covers, defines the boundary or the monopoly of the invention. What is the complete section 10.4? It shall fully and particularly describe the invention and its operation or use and the method in which it is to be performed. Should be completely written. Disclose the best method of performing the invention. The example. By which you can perform this method in a best manner. Then description, what does it contain? It must mention very comprehensively. Okay, you take the help of the literature from the SciFinder, generalize in a manner and describe your invention comprehensively. What is done? What are the lacunas there? And how it is different from those what is already available? It should fully explain solve. What are the problems earlier people they were not able to solve? By which invention, by my invention, these problems, how I solve it? There is no ambiguity. Once you are writing the description, there should not be any ambiguity. In writing, you should be very confident. It should be adequate and sufficient so as to enable a person skilled in the art to perform the repeat and invent. Okay, this is very important. So describe your invention in a fully manner. Again, to reflect that invention, write the what is the novelty of your invention. What is the inventive step and how does it industrially applicable and how it is patentable under the Indian patent law. Five points which are very important in the description. Then what is the content? These are the headings. Title, you give a catchy title. Field of the invention, under which field it is. What is the background of the invention described fully? What is the prior, what people they have done earlier in this area? Summarize the whole, okay? The object of the invention, and according to that, what is the object of my, what is the statement of my invention, and give the detailed description of the invention. These are the parts which are covered in the patent, okay? So to write the title, it should be a concise statement providing the crux of the. You write a title in such a way that it will provide the care should be taken to incorporate all major aspects claimed. Try to see that the title should be very catchy and covers these things. We go for product, process, and the apparatus. example, brush, but for which we are calling cleaning article. If you write the cleaning article, everything is covered, including the brush. Similarly, the pen versus the writing instrument. I am writing instrument in my patent, so everything is covered, not only the pen, whatever the instrument which I am able to use for writing, that is covered. And the field of invention gives the more details than the type which field it is falling down, provides what is the utility. It is very important, whatever you have done, whatever you have produced, what is the this material or utility of the product. Sometimes used as a tool, sense of the abstract. Most of the times these terms are used for background, provides the technical background of the invention, give the technically prior art. Again, as I told you, do the literature thing. Standard search engines like the SciFinder, okay, don't go for the Google, is most of the references, and write in a concise manner. So then if you see that, what is the different approach? These are the things known from this literature. I know that these are the prior arts. What's thing, and that becomes a part of my invention. Like this, I have shown here part of my invention. So you should be able to summarize your literature. You should get some kick that there is some point missing mentions that becomes a part of my invention. Okay. Then some answers you can write in the prior art. Prior art solution not working. So even though patent is published and we are trying to repeat those, prior art solution is doesn't working, and you did some temperature increase change, then it can become a part of the patent. Okay, describe adequately. Whatever is the new solution which you have developed, you describe in a fully manner. Then it object of the invention, basically it provides purpose of this invention. Why I am doing this invention, how it is useful. Object and what are the ancillary objects? What are the essential aspects and the optional aspects? Okay. And what is in the state of the invention? It forms the main claim or the claims in the verbal agreement. It is essential only when there is an ambiguous claims. You describe fully, says the best mode of performing, give the example of performing the invention, describe the invention in a greater detail with example illustrations, tables, graphs, diagrams, etc. Describe to enable a skilled person in the put invention into practice. Claim is basically very important, especially the first claim. First claim is the heart of our able to devise the first claim in a nice manner, then rest of the claim, the first claim. The main claim defines the essential features and the subclaims. Defines the preferred optional additional features. The important is need not be merged into the other claim. A separate claim has to be formed on features. Is the operative part of the specification monopoly to be conferred by the patent? It defines the bounds of the invention at the time of infringement. Prosody claims will be interpreted. If you don't claim properly, then you will be disclaimed. Do's and don'ts in invention, generic expressions should be substantially supported properly. The names should be familiar to the person in the skilled art. Point terms, names should be clearly described. So these are the do's. The list continues. The specification must describe very concise. It should explain the problem to be solved. The example. There should not be any ambiguity while writing the examples. It should be adequate and sufficient so as to enable in the art of invention. Substance per se give the broad cover. Okay. Learn the language, how to write those languages. Okay. Words. Substance can be defined in terms of nomenclature, general formula, structural formula, constituents, properties, or the structural features, use, etc. So use different structures. Then product per se, write the composition or the synergistic mixture, continuation product, enhance efficacy, describe essential ingredients or the composition. This is for the chemical invention. Then ratio, percentage, then their effective amounts or any optional or the additional. Then again, starting materials, step of the process, it is like temperature, time, pressure, catalyst, catalyst concentration, and what is proportions, do's and don'ts provide a broad range. Suppose I must have used 0.2% of catalyst, but try to cover from maybe 0.001 to maybe 2% or maybe 5% coverage. Provide a broad workable range unless an exact amount is essential to the success of the enemy. Specify the class and specify the for the chemical patents. All the oxidants that would be enabled like this. Fundamental search, PCR technique, write PCR specification to describe the general art, approach which was adopted in the work, then detail enabling process and the best mode of performing. Avoid negative examples. Never give any negative examples into writing. Vast difference in the IC50 values of anti-cancer different courses. An anti-cancer drug effect, these are some of the examples. Okay, so avoid such type of examples. Independently worded claims, easy to mention, easy to search, easy to license, and easy to infringement. So while writing the claims, you must take care. How to characterize the claims? Characterization possible in many cases. Most of the times, it is very difficult to characterize the claim. Be characterized, okay? Even if characterized, subclaims need not be restricted to the characterized part. Imprisonment, you must have seen, studies most of the times, this person's patent has been imprisoned by somebody. Some other imprisonment. What is mean by imprisonment? Imprisonment of a patent occurs, competitor makes, uses, sells, offers to sell, or imports an embodiment of the invention without of the patent owner. Then imprisonment comes into picture. And the studies how XYZ company has imprisoned to the ABC company. So what is imprisonment? I have shown here by diagram. This is imprinting component which is coming within the circle. This is my claim and imprinting embodiment. Then only imprisonment comes. Okay. Imprisonment, again, primary imprisonment, secondary imprisonment. This making the product, secondary commercial activities, selling, etc. Secondary imprisonment sales, let us for hire or buy, to offer for sale or hire any imprinting copies, to distribute copies or importing into Malaysia. What is imprisonment? This type of remedies for lot of big damage, lot of remedies are. What is patent? Only cover those products or process described by the claims. An imprint or process must have each element of the claim. The act or process may have more than required by the claim. Imprisonment, determine the meaning of the claim. Read the claim very determine the meaning, how the claims are constructed. Apply the meaning device, like literal imprisonment or the doctrine of the equivalent. So checklist, verify the following before filing a patent. Conduct the search, again by using proper search engine. Mention patentable, again and again, you answer this. Has it been ascertained whether complete or the provisional is to be filed? Enlist problems in the prior art. What is the problem solved by my invention? Is the solution obvious? Non-patentable items. Okay, checklist, specific Indian deposition, source, origin. This is for these cultures. All details, experiment data, examples, tables, graphs, and drop the text. Once you are ready with this, then what is the patent filing process? Patent. What are the stages? Okay. Filing of application, again provisional or complete, then publication of the application, the timelines, request for examination, then exams, the first examination report, that is called FER, then grant of patent, then decision of the controller, appeal and the appeal. This is the structure of the stages of filing or granting a patent. Then once you file a patent, how you get the report from the filing, then request for examination, first examination report, it takes to response, then discussion hearing and the acceptance. Okay. Then after a certain time period, you will get such type of examination report, FPR, from the patent attorney, government patent office. Then he will highlight some of the problems enlisted into your invention. Then you have to he will clearly write what he has not understood, where there are any problems. Especially he will read the claims very carefully. Okay. Then you can get the ISR and IPR, okay, reports, objection, international search report, then unity of invention, file detailed response, then the examiners, like in this, okay, then seeking hearing time 10 days before the final, like this, into this goes into the different time periods. Then I will come to the World Intellectual Property or WIPO convention, where we file the PCT, that is PCT application. What is the WIPO? Okay, WIPO came into existence 1970. Convention was signed in 1960. Was in 1970. In 1974, WIPO becomes a UN agency. WIPO was born from the merging of Paris and Bern Convention. These two conventions were merged, and then WIPO came into picture. What are the advantages basically the IPO? Protection worldwide. Suppose you want to file a patent worldwide. Okay, this is the agency. Then to ensure administrative cooperation among the IPO unions established by the world. And WIPO convention, objectives are achieved by activities, program activities, then international classification activities, and the registration activities. Headquarter, as I told you, it is Geneva, Switzerland. Then PCT, what is PCT? Patent cooperation. Okay, what is PCT? Why to file PCT application? What are the advantages? What are the recent PCT developments and all those? What is PCT? Procedural international treaty facilitating in the process of obtaining international patents. Okay, this is a procedure for filing and processing of a single application, which has a legal effect in the countries which are treaty. Okay, so PCT application sign the decision or granting patents is made exclusively by national or the regional offices in the national phase, signed in 1970 in Washington DC and became operational in June 1978 with 18 states. As of 27, this PCT 30, now it is more than that, it is about 144 countries. Then once you file the PCT, then you get the international search report of the examiners. Then publication of report, WIPO website, it comes. Then national patent by supplying the translation of the application. Then the national fees, they take about 18 months. Why to file the PCT in multiple countries? Suppose I want to claim my invention in multiple countries. Yeah. Then you go for the PCT filing. Okay, if you are filing only Indian patent, only in India, you will be covered only in India. Okay, if patent has in PCT is the answer. PCT is not an international patent. Don't ask that the PCT is an international. This is basically agency where you file the. Okay, the PCT is a window through which an single patent application and secure priority in the design states. Single window application and give the priority where you want to take the protection of your invention. Then search report evaluates the invention, then examination report optional. This is basically the toolkit. It goes the patentability analysis, harmonized formalities, global visibility, electronic filing, buys time and protects. So first application, once you file, you sign file in different countries. Okay, so application. Okay, the PCT headquarters in Geneva. Then this is the timeline. Okay, how it goes in the different steps. The filing, the sign by India, effective December 7, 1998, about 148 countries are now the members. These are the countries of the member of the PCT. Here I have shown here our India, and this is the website of the PCT, www.wipo.int/PCT. If you want Ian, and you can get all the tutorials, all the information given on this website. Okay, this is a very describes each and everything. Okay, then I don't have other figures here now. It has evolved from 92 till date in a very rapid manner, and you see the filing indications how it has evolved. Okay, in 1978, very few. Now you can see at how it is going. Then these are the some old slide, but you can get the data after this year also. So it has evolved like this. So this is basically how the filing system goes. First is file local application, then file PCT application, then international search report, then 0, 12, 18, 16, 18, 20, and 30 application. So like this goes into different steps. I have shown here at zero level, typically a national patent application in the home that is filed after 12 months, typically filed in the same national patent, one set of fees, one language, one set of formality requirements. Then after 16 months, report on state of the art of the practice. 18 months, disclosing to world content of application and the standardized way. At 22 months, request an additional patentability analysis on the basis of amended claims. 28 months, additional patentability analysis designed in national phase and the decision making. And at the last 30 months, the take steps to pursue to grant in various states. 0 to 12 months, these are the steps I have shown here. Will not go into this. I already discussed this. Advantage: the PCT is the cornerstone of the international, provides a worldwide system for simplified filing, and like this, it postpones the major costs associated with the internationalizing a patent. Provides a strong basis for patenting decisions. Harmonizes requirements. Then protects applicant from certain in advance. Involves to meet the user needs is used by the operators, universities, research institution. Okay, so these are so many advantages of the PCT filing. Quality of PCT international phase work products, building trust between patent office so that the duplicate international phase and the national phase processing can be reduced. Language issues, 33 application filing in Chinese, Japanese, and the Korean. Helping developing benefit from the PCT, 15 countries responsible for 92.1% in 2011. So these are some of the challenges faced by the PCT. Why to use PCT and what are the advantages? As I discussed so many things, the world within the reach, then postpones the major costs associated with patent application. Then provides a strong basis for patenting decisions issued by the world's major corporators and allow you to supply securely. Then how PCT application within the reach, I have shown here. Then postpones associated with the international filing patent application. Then what are those large initial costs? Basically, translation of patent application, which are documents into various national languages, official fees for payment in the regional patent offices, then fees for the services of the local patent agents. Where are the costs involved? I have shown here the different costs, and I will show now the where are the costs involved. Okay, basically cost involved. So once you file the PCT application, international search report, okay, and the written opinion of the international authority, then in chapter 2 of the treaty, it is the international preliminary report on the patentability analysis. Okay, you will get it. Once you file the PCT application, you will get this type of report. What is the first one? It symbols indicating which aspect of patentability cited is relevant or irrelevant. For example, novelty, invention, etc. The examiner will point out here. In the second stage, it's relevant to whether or not your invention may be patentable. Okay. Documents if invention is patentable or not patentable. The claims here you write the claim numbers in your application. Document is relevant. Like this, you will get the report from the examiners. And in the second reasoning or supporting the assessment, you will get these type of comments. Then patentability assessment of the claims. So you will get such type of report from the examiners. What does the after receiving the application, then he has to react with these queries and reply PCT within a short period of time. I have shown here how these different countries, they are filing year-wise patent application, PCT applications. Okay, you can see a big list of who are very aggressive in filing the PCT applications. Which are the companies who are leading? LG, LG Electronics, LG Innorec Company Limited, Samsung Electronics and Telecommunication, Seoul National University, Pohang National. Then I have an opportunity to work with these three companies when I was in Korea, and I have worked with them very closely. And I was involved in developing some material for the digital data storage. I held several patents with them, so I know their culture, I know their language, and protect the intellectual property. Most of the things I have learned from this course. Then apply securely and easily online money for doing so. So like this, you will get the report, file the PCT application. Once you do the electronic filing, these steps, okay. Basically, these are the charges for the paper filing, electronic filing. Filings, okay. This chart shows that year wise the percentage of PCT applications, how many applications have been filed. Okay. What are the recent developments in the PCT applications? Effective from 2007, restoration of the right of priority, application filed with the Paris Missing, then addition of patent documents public to the Korea. Then from but it use the results of an earlier search, PCT rule 12. Then use of email addresses for receiving communication. Like this all came. What are the amendments to the PCT regulation from 1st January 2009? Entry international search, PCT rule. Then Korean PCT publication language. Okay, things we are working on. They are working on so many different things till today. Then future PCT issues, these are the issues you may be facing in future. Or so which are the companies, which are the countries who are aggressive in filing the PCT? The countries I have shown here, okay, Japan, Korea, China. So like this patent filing is going on. These are the different countries, and these are the numbers for US, Japan, Denmark, Korea. Okay. So these are the PCT applicants, very aggressive companies who are aggressive in filing patents, universities who are aggressive in filing the patents. This is Institute of Advanced Technology, where I worked for about 2 years. Scientist. And I learned so many things from them. Okay. This is a list of the government institutes internationally. And I am very happy to show here that our Council and Industrial Research is falling under the category 13. Okay. Once you submit the PCT, then you get this type of report, search report. Okay. These are some of the examples I have shown here. You get the search. Examiner's PCT office. Okay. Budapest Treaty. India signed this treaty in 17 December 2001. The deposition of the microorganism for the purpose of patent made available to the grant. And then international recognized depository, we are, that is IMTEC Chandigarh, Institute of Microbial Technology. So once you file the PCT application, this is the first page of the PCT. How does it look like? These are the countries, designated countries where you are applying. These are the name of the your institutes where this application came. This is CSIR, and this is the name of the, you can see my name and the other names, okay? And these are the examiners. This is the title and this is the abstract. So the first page look like this. And then you file the US patent, the US patent will look like this. This is the first page of the US patent where you can see filing date. This is the title and this is the institute who is filing. This is the patent issued to one of my students who is from North Maharashtra University, who worked at the School of Chemical Science. He joined my group, he worked with me, and he has produced several patents. Then this is another patent. You can see here, this is my name, she is my wife, she is my director. Then file the European patent application. You can see the first page of the European patent application. This is the Korean patent. You can see the first, the Korean patent application. And this is our typical first page of the Indian patent. So I am coming to almost the end of my talk. What is required for filing a patent? What is required for, you should have brilliant idea, age doesn't matter. I am showing a of Hardeshwar Singh Bhatti, whose age years, okay, from city of, he has invented a six-player variant chess first time for his brilliant idea, and a patent has been filed, has been granted to me. Friends, always keep in mind, age doesn't matter, idea matters. What is the brilliant idea? What is the novelty? What is the inventive step? And what is the non-obviousness? If your solves this, gives the answer to these three questions, then person can file a patent. Okay. These are some of the important from, you get the information, okay, on the nic.in, WIPO.int. So if you want to read so many all literature, you can go to these websites and read this material. Books, suppose you, after your graduation, post-graduation, you qualify as a patent agent, okay? Then you can read only this book, the examination which government of India is conducting, and then qualify, then you can become a patent agent. This is the only book. From this book, they ask several questions. And this is the additional book. If you are interested, buy the book, the only cost 160 rupees, but you can read most of the info. Okay. Finally, I wish to thank to my team, for my students, supporters, well-wishers, and for my directors, all with whom I work at my place. This is my laboratory from, okay, where I worked about 38 years of my service. I will stop here now. And if you have any questions, you can ask.
Okay, now we shall proceed with the question answer session. The audience are welcome to put forward their queries, if any, before our esteemed speaker, Dr. B.B. Idge sir. I think so there are questions. You can just raise your hand so that we can give the spotlight on you. Dr. Rakesh, please give a spotlight.
Yes. Yes, sir.
I think so. In the chat box, there is one question. Intellectual property rights of a data collected and constituted by PhD student during the preparation of their thesis. Is it, sir?
Yes.
Intellectual property rights of a data collected and constituted by PhD student during the preparation of their thesis, during the preparation of their thesis, the data collected or constituted by the PhD students, is it the intellectual property right?
No, basically, I want to make a PhD thesis. Okay.
Yes,
most of these times, the student do the and they publish their work in the different journals. Okay. He is not aware that there is some intellectual property hidden problem. Okay. First yes, of sir. All, he should differentiate what intellectual property he is going to generate during his thesis. Okay. Is it what is required for patentability? I have given a big list. He is able to answer those questions. Then first you file a patent, go for publication. Okay. But most yes, of the times we are in very much publish it. Okay. Because people, they are very much interested in impact factor. That yes, is the problem. Okay. Yes. And in hurry, okay, once you publish it and somebody make use of that knowledge and go for development. So my request to all the PhD students is that you decide, is there any intellectual property I am working on, or whatever the problems I'm working on, I am going to develop some intellectual property problem. If it is coming, then first file a patent.
Okay, sir.
First file a patent, then after six months, eight months, you are ready to, okay? But don't be in a hurry to publish that work in a conference or like Avishkar. So many times I come to Avishkar, okay? Most tell the students, why you are not filed the patents? He says, sir, I don't know. Teacher, this is the problem. And he opens his, he has developed, and somebody will make use of that knowledge. So before coming presentations or the conferences, his responsibility and his guidance is that they should go for a patent filing first. The intellectual okay, property he is going to develop. Okay, that is my request.
Sir, there is a one more okay, question from Dr. Shisode, has just raised hand. Mm-hmm. Please, Rakesh sir, mm-hmm, give the spotlight to Dr. Shisode. Is it possible, Dr. Rakesh?
Yes, sir, it is okay, possible. Shisode sir, kindly accept the second button. Kindly Dr. accept the second button. Mute yourself, unmute yourself.
Dr. Shisode, please ask your question. If you are hearing us,
I think he is not able to unmute
okay
himself. Sir, there are more questions in question answer session.
Yes.
You can ask that.
Dr. Rajvardhan Kapishkar asked about what is the expiry period for Indian patent, sir? What is the expiry period of 16?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. And for US and any other country?
Similarly, okay, different year wise, it is given, it is known in the literature. Okay,
yes. Again, one more question.
If you go to any IPO, if you any yes, website of our Indian patent website, everything is given there.
Yes, what is the PCT number, sir? Kishore Kumar Das asking from Odisha.
Patent Cooperation Treaty.
Patent Cooperation Treaty. Okay.
Basically, this is an agency, but once you file the patent number, will become in the form of WO. WO.
WO.
Number will come. Okay. Yes.
Dr. Harshal Bhamre from SSBS College asked, what criteria required to file a patent of transgenic microorganism? Transgenic microorganism. What are the criteria required?
For filing a patent of microorganism, there are different criteria. They are not like the other patent filing. Okay. So basically, you have to discuss this type of criteria in Chandigarh. Okay. IMTEC Chandigarh is our CSIR lab. They are taking the filing of the microorganism patents. Okay.
Okay. Yes. And again, Kishore Kumar Dash asked about what are the limitations of PCT. Limitations PCT
means
PCT. What is the
limitation? PCT? Means what? PCT is a world patent application that is called Patent Cooperation Treaty. A patent, and you can get the coverage about 146 countries. But the patent filing fees is about 1 lakh rupees. Okay.
Yes. 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 So here we stop for the question answer session, sir. Very nicely, you just enlightened us on the intellectual property rights. You just covered big. What is a patent? What is a trademark? What is the industrial design? What are copyright and related rights? What is the word intellectual property organization? So many topics you covered in within a very short time. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Patient hearing.
Thank you. Dear participants, we will proceed for the further session. Before that, I would like to announce one thing. There will be the webinar on 3rd and 4th of June on COVID-19 impact, challenges and innovation in education system and NAC on dated 3 and 4 of June by organized by our college, Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstas, late Karma with Dr. P.R. Gogre Science College. And at the end of this session, there will be the valedictory function, and it will be inaugurated by Honorable Dr. S.T. Patil, Vice President of Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha. So you should all remain present up till valedictory function. Now we will proceed for the second session, resource person second, that is Dr. Niranjan Yevale sir, scientist from National Chemical Laboratory, Pune. I'd like to invite Dr. Chetan Patil to give the introduction of Dr. Niranjan Yevale sir. Dr. Chetan Patil, please.
Am I audible to you all?
Yes, yes, continue.
At the outset, I welcome all the delegates, panelists, and participants for the last session of National E-Seminar on Cyber Security, Cyber Forensics, and Intellectual Property Rights. For this session, we have very young and distinguishing guest with us, Dr. I feel proud to introduce Dr. as my research colleague during our doctoral studies and a very good friend of mine. Dr. Niranjan is presently working as a scientist in a CSIR National Chemical Laboratory, NCL, where he is associated with intellectual property group. The group within CSIR NCL shoulders the responsibility of implementing and managing intellectual property portfolios of technologies and innovations in NCL. He has contributed 10 research papers in the journals of international repute. He has completed his master's degree in polymer chemistry and PhD and doctoral studies under the guidance of Professor D.G. Mundiwale sir in the group of Professor D.G. Mundiwale sir, Professor Parkar Maharashtra University, Jalgaon. Dr. Niranjan was also associated with the University of Hyderabad as a D.S. Kothari postdoc fellow. His areas of scientific expertise are the development of nanomaterials and polymer conjugates, surfactant-free emulsions and rapid polymerization. He has also completed a postgraduate diploma in patents law from Nalsar University of Hyderabad, India. He has a very long industry experience. He was associated with the PI Industries Rajasthan and Dolcera ITs Hyderabad. Presently, his focus on CSIR focus areas in CSIR NCL are to shape and manage intellectual property portfolios of NCL, to contribute in the activities of intellectual property group of NCL. With this brief introduction, now I'd like to request Dr. Niranjan, please share your knowledge and perceptive experiences with us to make this session of e-seminar fruitful one. Thank you, sir.
Yes, yes. Thank
now
you,
I request
Dr. Chetan.
Professor Kembur, sister, kindly share the screen, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Before that, I would like to request Principal Dr. M.V. Patil, sir, to felicitate Dr. Niranjan Yevale, sir, scientist of National Chemical Laboratory, Pune. by offering a bouquet. Please increase the volume. I think so. There is one chat. Okay. Yes. Now this is the time for the second resource person, Dr. Niranjan Yavale sir, with us on the topic of intellectual property rights. Please, sir. Dr. Niranjan Yavale sir.
Yeah.
Enlighten us. Yeah.
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you are audible.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, first of all, thank you to the management for inviting me for this delivering lecture on intellectual property right. As I can see, the previous lecture was a very exhaustive one, which has covered most of the IP related aspect. But during the presentation, I modified my presentation by deleting some of the content. It should not be kind of a repetitive one, so that audience should not feel it's a repeated version of the previous talk. So with this, I'll share my screen. Is it visible?
No, sir. Just click the share option.
Yeah.
So that.
Is it visible now?
Yes, sir. Do it in a presentation mode.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So even the title has changed during the last presentation. So I tried my best to avoid the repetition. So let's see about the patenting process and way forward. How the patenting process generally takes place, and what are the benefit? How and how the industries play the role in managing their IP and strategizing their IP. So this is a kind of a brief outline which I'll be presenting. The first part will have a patent application and a patent life cycle. How patent moves from filing stage up to the grant stage. What are the processes are involved? We will see into it. And the other section will be I will give on the case study on chloranthralipron. This is a insecticide molecule which is a product of DuPont, which is a blockbuster molecule. I will highlight IP aspect for this specific molecule. So other one, the last part will be the post COVID-19. What are the changes has taken place and how the learning has came very efficiently for all the person who wanted to learn remotely. So this is a slide which was already discussed by Dr. Ekke sir. So this is a ordinary application. There are multiple application which we can file in patent office. And the first step is the ordinary application. Along with the ordinary application, you can file a divisional as well as patent of addition application. So you have to consider the ordinary application as a first filing for your invention. Whereas a divisional, when you file your application and examiner finds out that your application is having a multiple invention and the patent is granted only for a single invention, not for the multiple invention, he will ask you to divide your application and you have to file a divisional application. So you will have a two patent application running parallelly. Whereas patent of addition is kind of a application where you modify your earlier application, your invention, and then you go with the patent of addition kind of application. All this will have a same term of patent life, that is 20 years from the date of filing. Now we'll talk about international application. Suppose an international applicant, the person who is residing in outside India, he has to file his application into India. He cannot file ordinary application as if he is not an Indian national. So he has to go through either two routes, either a Paris Convention route or a PCT route. So the Paris Convention is, they had filed their application in their local jurisdiction, and within 12 months they can file their complete application in India. So they cannot file a provisional application over India. They will file directly complaint. So what is the problem associated with it? The cost, translation. For example, the Chinese application is there. They will have their Chinese application and they have to translate it before filing it in India. So what they have to do it within 12 months from the date of filing. So the cost factor will come over here. And about the PCT application, you have a advantage. We'll talk about it briefly. Even though Dr. Itke has explained a lot, but still I will highlight few of the points. So, for example, they had filed here as the first filing in their local jurisdiction. Within 12 months, they will file the PCT application as a complete application. From 12 months to 16 months, the PCT will generate an international search report and a written opinion on the invention which you have filed. They will cite few of the citations which were causing an objection to your invention in terms of novelty, inventive step, as well as utility. So this is a chance for an applicant to modify or amend their claim set to go further. So you could amend your claim set, which can go through substantial examination free flowing without any hurdles in future. And these amendments were filed as an Article 19 amendment. So that comes over here. During 16 months, the Article 19 amendment you can file. And whatever the amendments you have given to the PCT, it will be published along with your original PCT application, that is here at the time of 12 months period. So that along with this PCT application, your amended claim set will be published at the 18 months period time. So now there is another part. During 22 months, there is an optional facility available. Even with the amended claim set, those will not be prosecuted by the patent PCT cell. If you ask them for having an examination, they will do the patentability search at the time of 20 months. Means you have to file a request at the 22 month, and they will give you the report around 28 months, whether your invention is a they don't have any objection with respect to novelty, inventive state, or any other related objections. So what is the benefit of having this two filters at the Article 19? Article 19 is a cost free. You can amend your claims at free of cost, which is a very beneficial in terms of examination, because examination affair is not as easy. Because if you go in the US, you will have to pay a lot for the every prosecution will cost you $1,000. So $1,000. So you have to very judiciously take benefit of PCT rule to have the foreign filing application. So once after 28th month, you will get this report and it will be published. And this is at 28 months when you file a demand at 22 months, that is Article 34, the chapter second, which Dr. Ijed has already explained. Suppose you don't file demand, what will happen? Whatever the international search report and written opinion is being given at the 16 month period, it will be considered as an international preliminary report on patentability. And though that will be delivered to the national jurisdiction where you want to enter. Now, you can see the cost involved at this period, that is 12 months in Paris Convention, it was extended till 30th month. So you have another extra 18 months of period time to take a decision whether to enter into other jurisdiction or not, whether your invention will sustain or it will be objected, and you cannot overcome the objection raised by the national of patent offices. So in this way, the PCT is having a very beneficial route. If your invention is really of importance, always try to go through the PCT route, even if it is a costly affair. But in terms of, if you calculate overall patent costing, it's a really effective way to move ahead. So now I will talk about the patent life cycle, which is already explained, but a few of the points extra in detail I will talk about. So filing of patent application. Before filing a patent application, you should be ready with your search. You have to see whether your invention is really new and inventive, then only you should proceed. It's not a compulsory, but it's an optional one, but you should do your homework before filing any invention. So there are two routes. First is you directly file a complete specification. So without filing any provisional, you go with the complete specification, which will be published after 18 months. However, there is a scope. If you request for early publication, your application will publish before reaching to the 18 months period of time. The other way is around, you file a provisional specification, but here you have to file your complete specification within 12 months after provisional specification. If you file that complete application, your application will get published. What if you don't file your complete specification within 12 months? Your application deemed to be abandoned. It will not be live. It's kind of a dead patent. And even it is not going to publish, as if you have not filed your complete specification, it will not be published as well. What happens once your application is published? There are people who are not as an academics, but industry, they will hunch for the invention which is coming into their part. So they will file a pre-grant opposition after publication of application. So when someone files this pre-grant opposition, he has to request for examination. Otherwise, if someone doesn't go for this pre-grant opposition, you have to file request for examination on Form 18 of Indian Patent Office within 48 months of date of priority. That means filing of your patent application. Within 14 months, you have to request for examination. What if you don't file the request of examination? Your application won't be examined. It's again going to be last or abandoned. So there is another way, that expedited examination, like we can do early publication request. There is an option for expedited examination, which is available for startups and applicant which indicate India as an ISA, that is an international search authority, through the PCT route. They can file this expedited examination. What is the benefit? If your invention is really market ready, you have to do your examination at the earliest to get it granted. Once it is granted, then only you can have the patent rights protected. Now, once the examination is done, what will happen? The FER will be issued. That is, the first examination report will be issued by Patent Office, Indian Patent Office. They will give you all the objections in terms of novelty, inventive step, as well as if there are non-patentable subject matter, that will also come. If you have a any biological resource in your patent application, you will have to obey the Biodiversity Act. You have to also highlight that this is the source of this material, this is the origin of material, and if that material is very new, you have to deposit according to Budapest Treaty, and all the details has to be highlighted in your specification. These all kinds of objection or information that will be highlighted in FER. Now, after FER, the examination office duty will be on hold. Now, your duty will start. You have to revert or response within 6 months period time. If you don't do so, if you don't reply to the FER and your objections are not overcome, your application deemed to be abandoned. And if what you overcome the objection, you amend your claims as well as specification accordance to the examination report, your patent will get granted under section 43R. It will be published as the granted patent. Now, do you think that your duty is over once the patent is granted? No. There is a like pre-grant opposition, there is a also post-grant opposition. But here the pre-grant opposition can be filed by any person. But here in post-grant, the person interested in the field can file the post-grant opposition. As if this is a post-grant opposition is a costly affair. So people, those who are a normal person, they do pre-grant opposition instead of post-grant. And post-grant, it generally goes according to the industry. Industry deals with, they think, without any granted patent, if they're, that is hindering their product to go into the market, they will definitely file the post-grant opposition. Now, even there is no post-grant opposition, there is still your duty pending. You have to maintain your patent. If you don't maintain it without paying a annual fees, your patent still get lapsed because of non-payment issue. So you have to maintain your patent if you want to have your invention protected. So that duty is still your 20th year. Every year you have to pay, but even you can pay a blanket payment in terms of multiple years as well. So now how industry work? We'll talk about industry. Generally what they do a technology landscape. Even the industry is focused towards a single criteria, means they will be having a management. They will decide on which invention, in which part portfolio they will be filing the application. That is an internal decision. They will have a technology landscape ready. And landscape, what it will have? It will give you the details of competitors, those who are working in that field. What is the technology trend? All these details will be present in the landscape, technology landscape study. The other part before filing, the patentability assessment has to be done. And industry does this. Without that patentability assessment, they don't go for filing. Why? Because once the office action ends for in terms of Indian patent, FER, first examination report, you have to ready what questions will come from the patent office. You have to be ready with your rebuttals and compile all the information. And this is again beneficial. Suppose you have a process which you wanted to have a protection, but that process is for single molecule, but you can cover that kind of all molecules if you find in novelty that there is no any filing in this area. You can broaden your scope of invention. And as I said, this is to strategy keep ready for defense during prosecution. Now I'll come to the case study, which is related to chloranthraniliprole. I guess the audience, most of them are from a farming background, but still they will not understand what is this molecule is all about. But when I will go into the next slides, you will understand, okay, everybody was knowing this product, but they don't know what active ingredient that product is having. This is a chloranthraniliprole. That's a Rynaxypyr is a trade name for that molecule. It is a DuPont product. It's a diamide insecticide, where you can see it's a reverse diamide, CONH, and this attachment of carbonyl amide is different. before this molecule were also there, those were kind of a CONH CONH instead of CONH NHCO. So now I can guess coragen by seeing coragen word, many people will connect, those who are from the farming background, that coragen is a formulation which is having a chloranthranilipril as an active ingredient in that formulation. So this is the trademark they have registered. Now for this chloranthranilipril, this is having a billion US dollar market for this particular molecule. The first filing was in 2001. They have a priority date in 2001. And around this molecule, DuPont has filed almost 60 patent applications. That is till 2012. And they have also covered other diamides which were active, near active for this particular molecule. And they have another process 17 application, as well as other formulation and mixture, as well as various uses of such animal health. Such kind of protection they did for a single molecule, so that you can understand how industry works for having their successful product, that by multiple filing, by fencing all aspects of invention, so that nobody should enter into it. That's the reason they were having a billion dollar molecule. Now, how industry always try to find a new way to means a discovery setup. So they have came with a new molecule. This is a sintranilipril. It's in the same chemistry. Only the substitution of chlorine is been replaced by cyanide. And because of this simple change of one substituent, this whole physicochemical properties of this molecule has changed a lot. That is, the log P is around 1.9 and aqueous solubility raised up to 14 ppm. And because of this cyanide substitution, they got a broad insecticidal spectrum. For example, in hemipterian pests such as Mysis pyrsi and hoppers, for example, grasshoppers. So by coming from chloranthranilipril to sintranilipril, they had a new product filing, that particular molecule. Even though that was covered in the first patent application in 2001, they cleverly filed this another application to have a extended protection. For example, if 2001, that your product patent will expire in 2021. Now, because of this sintranilipril filing, which was after the 17 months of the previous application, they could extend their patent protection by another 17 months for this new molecule. And even they have filed this process patent for just Cl to Cn conversion. So you have to understand the market. You have to understand the very inventive aspect of your invention, because somebody will say, okay, by changing this much, what is there by changing from chlorine to cyanide? No, it's a huge market potential. These both molecules are going through. And detailed history, you can go through this references, which I will share in the chat box. You can go and you will understand how industry plays, or how they utilize the intellectual property rights for monetary gain, as well as the branding name of their product. So now everybody might have seen this picture. It's a very dots. I illustrated in terms of patent. So consider this, all these circles as in one single patent. And if you have a multiple filing, you have to have a strong strategy for all kinds of IP management. If you don't have a strong management or strategy behind IP filing, you will not go to the successful product. You have to be proper management and strategy in place to reach this successful product. Now, I told you this molecule is from the DuPont. Now, because you might have heard about the Dow-DuPont merger, these industries are well into the market. And because of this merger, the Competition Commission ruling, they have to diversify their portfolio. Now, even this molecule belong to DuPont, they have to transfer their molecule to FMC. FMC has acquired this molecule from DuPont because of the Competition Commission of government. They have to diversify their portfolio so that they should avoid a monopoly. If what happens if the single person is having a monopoly over all kinds of portfolio, they will take a disadvantage of IP protection. They will charge the people at the way they want. But as this Competition Commission is there, they will look after the social cause as well. They will not allow few things which are anti-social. So the because of this, FMC got this health nutrition. And because of that, FMC was nowhere in the top five. It came as a global crop protection company at the fifth place. And they had paid almost more than $1 billion cash transaction to DuPont along with their health and nutritional division. Now, I'll come to this last part of the session. Post-COVID-19, how the scenarios has changed and how you can get the benefit of IP learning. You have to go through this patent scope site, that is a PCT site, where you will have the COVID-19 impact. They have the new website launched itself for COVID-19. I will try to give you live demonstration. One second. So I will talk about the search strategy. The search strategy can be done according to the keyword search as well as the classification code. IP offices have, if you do a keyword search only, like Dr. Ikki has already explained, only Google search won't do good if you believe on only Google search. You have to have extra database or paid database. If not paid database, at least for the academics, you should try the patent scope, which is a free version. You can go and check that whether your invention is really worth, it will cross the bar of novelty as well as inventive step. You can find the prior arts from patent scope. Now, the benefit of using patent scope, they have even included a chemical structure search. But for that, you need to have an account. And that account is free of cost. Each one of you can create an account and utilize this database to explore further. I'll try to... So this is what the site I was talking about, Patent Scope WIPO International Search COVID-19. So this is related to all, they have broadly categorized. Can you see my web page?
No, sir. Please share your screen.
Now you can see?
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Okay. So this is what the Patent Scope website under the COVID-19 especially. You can see this broad categories that Patent Scope has created for artificial respiration, diagnostic, disinfection, all kinds of COVID-19 related information or the prior arts you can find over here. Now, for example, if I do for diagnostic, you have to go this way, open new link. So you can find this. This is what I was talking about, class code A61H31. This is particularly for artificial respiration or heart stimulation or heart message. So you will find that all the technologies are compiled in the specific class codes. If you do a keyword search, you will not reach to the particular priority which you want to go for. So this kind of limitations are always good to have a reaching to the particular relevant hit. Now what we'll do, we'll go to this. So now if I click into here, EN, that's a, you will go directly to the this compilation, what they have as a prior art. You can see, is it visible now? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
And you can view the next web page which I landed into. So you can reach to such kind of related prior arts or publications. Now, if you want to see a chemical structure or chemical searching, you have to have login, as I said, and that is a free of cost. I request all of you to have your account on this WIPO IP portal. This will give you benefit. And even so many courses are available. I request you should go for it. And most of the courses are free of cost. You can do the courses with without any cost. So now you can see that you have the search string ready with this is a classification code as well as a text search. You will understand how patent office compile all the information in particular class codes as well as keywords options are available for this COVID-19 related aspect. Now I'll show you how you can go for chemical search. You go to this search option, you click on this chemical compound. Now, for example, the same molecule I will try, chloranthranilprole. Search for scaffold. Now you can see even the editor, like what we see in the ChemDraw. Now you can see that molecule has been already extracted from this database, and you can search for this particular molecule and reach to the search hits. Because of this, the windows, that options are search option when I'm not available on online or Zoom call, that option will be there as a search. You just have to search it and you will get into this result of it. All the related prior arts you will find out. Yeah, see, you can find out all this. This molecule has been covered by almost 7,375 results. These many hits have came. You can lower down by selecting the office. So these are multiple jurisdictions. You can limit your search depending on interest. Let's see, now we'll restrict it to India. Search. You can reduction in number. from 7,000 to almost less than around maybe 1,000 around it. Yeah, 315 results for a particular molecule. In that way, you can explore all your activity. So I'll conclude here. What we saw through this brief presentation about the patent application and a prior art. Okay, I forgot to talk about the secret prior art. You saw this in the slide that you file a patent application and it gets published after 18 months. During this part, your applications are kind of a secretly held with the patent office. Those are not. Is it visible, that slide, to you all?
Sir, it is visible.
Patent life cycle, you can see?
No. Just the screen is there where number 1 WO oblique KMIPOS.
Is it now?
No.
Sir, kindly share the complete screen.
Yeah. Now you can see, right? Is it visible?
Yes.
So this part is up to 18 months. Your application is secretly held with the patent office. It is not in the public domain. So while doing the search, they will do the search before this filing date of application. But what happens to the applications which were filed in this period? So they will be considered as a prior art, as a secret prior art. The other person who has filed before you will be a bar, that they will raise a bar on novelty aspect. Suppose he is has the same invention which you are working on, that in that case your invention will still be objected under novelty objection, even though it is not under inventive aspect, but novelty objection will be posed to you, that this application was filed before you, even though it is published after your filing application, but you have to deal with this objection and to overcome. And we saw what the DuPont strategy for that particular molecule and how it came. So IP is kind of a beneficial to all industries, how they take the benefit of IP. Otherwise, how they won't be getting this much of $1 billion opportunity. And we also saw the patent scope feature ready tool, which I believe all of you will have their own account and utilize it as if it is a free of cost. I request all the team to have their patent scope login ID. With this, thank you all. Yeah, I'm done with the presentation.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Sir, very brainstorming knowledge you give us. Non-stop, you are talking very fluently with full enthusiasm. Now there is a question answer session. Now we shall proceed with the question answer session.
Sure.
The audience are welcome to put forward their queries. I think so. There are questions in question answer box. Sir, there is one question from Kishore Kumar Dash. How much does it cost to get the patent?
Okay. If I talk about the cost, you will have to pay, it depends on jurisdiction where you want to protect your patent. For example, if you want to protect only in India, there is a variety of fee columns. If you are a natural person, means if you are a solo inventor without any industry and all, you will have a less amount of fee, approximately around 1600 for the filing. And if you are a small scale industry, you will have to pay almost 2.5 times of the natural person. Again, if you are a big industry, you will have to pay 5 times of the natural person fee. So it's like 8,000 goes up to 8,000 you have to file during filing your invention. Now, this is the case. Now, after that, you have, the payment cost will come when you are having a examination. During the examination, for during request for examination, you will have to pay fees as per the prescribed fees in the rules. So thereafter, after doing so, if your patent is granted for maintaining, you will have to pay again. It's every year it's it varies. For early years, it is like up to 4,000 per year, and thereafter it goes up to 24,000 also.
Okay, okay, sir. Yeah, there is one more question. In how many languages can I search a patent scope? How many languages?
Yeah, you can do it. But patent scope is very innovative. They have a Perl account where they have translated all other languages to the English domain. So you can find those details in WIPO as an Perl account. You will find all the translation keywords for the particular keyword you are searching for.
Yes, yes. Anybody wants to ask directly a question, please raise your hands. Audience, please. Participants, requested to raise your hand if you have any question regarding the. Meanwhile, I would like to. Yes, yes. There is a Kishore Kumar Deka from Odisha wants to ask. Please, Rakesh, Dr. Rakesh, give the spotlight to Dr. Kishore so that he can ask.
Kishore, sir, kindly ask your question.
Hello. Sir, if a product is being made by someone and he gets it patented, after that, he again makes too many modifications, can it be patented again?
As I said, they have to again go through this all objection. If you have a novelty is a simple, it's a black and white. If a prior art is not there, then obviously you will have a novelty. But there is always a gray area, inventive step. You have to prove that this is inventive over your earlier product. Until and unless you don't have innovative things into the next subsequent modification, it is difficult to prosecute.
Suppose a car is being manufactured or car engine is being manufactured or produced by someone. Yeah. It gets an average of 18 kilometers per liter. And suppose he makes a modification, it gets your say 25 kilometers per liter.
Obviously, they will get the patent protection definitely.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Kishore. Anybody again wants to be asked, please raise your hand. Meanwhile, there is one question from my side. Can a published research work can be patented?
If you are if your own work is been published in the scientific article, that's what you mean, right?
Yes, yes, sir.
So only India and US have a grace period of 12 months period from your date of publication of your scientific article. But again, you will have to defend your own published material, because you can have. And only these two jurisdictions, mostly I can see that grace period is allowed of 12 months period from the date of publication of your scientific article.
There is one more question from Dr. Rajvardhan Kapshikar. Another question is that many researchers do not look into patent database and come to know that work is already patented by company. Actually, it is in the question answer session.
I will say people should do the literature search in patent, because you will gain more learnings from patent database. Scientific database, all articles are not free, right? You will have to pay some amount. If you have an infinite account, that's okay. If you belong to school and all, a college and all. But if you are working as an individual, getting access to all such scientific article is kind of a difficult task. Whereas the patent database is a free database, means all patent offices have all the publication in domain as a free, you can have all the literature as a free availability. You have to go into patent database, and believe me, if you have all this, whatever I said about APR and the response, you will gain a much more knowledge than the scientific article, which is freehand. I understand that scientific article is having altogether it's a different their goal, whereas the patent is having a different goal. But I will request, along with the scientific article, go with the patent literature as well. And that too, it is available freely to all.
Yes, anybody wants to be asked? Okay. There is one more question. Which kind of index system does Patent Scope apply?
Index, I mean classification code, or what does it mean, index? I don't.
Index system. There is one question. Index system.
I did not get the point. Is it about a classification or some other part? If it is a classification, yes, they have an international patent classification as an IPC. All jurisdiction, for example, EP, European Union, is having their own CPC along with the US. They have a CPC classification.
Okay. Thank you very much. With this, Dr. Rajwardhan again asked one question. Names of search databases for chemistry, physics, and maths. Search database.
As an individual, free things, it depends what literature you want to search. For example, if you want to search a molecule, particular if you belong to organic chemistry, you will have ChemSure, that is a free version of, you can search the molecules and you can get the all the patent related literature from ChemSure. Whereas a SciFinder, it's a paid version. You will have to pay the fees. So that Google is also having, I can say, you can utilize as well Google search also. And all patent offices, you can go through their, they have their own search engines. Individual patent offices are having their own search engine. You can search to the related topic into their search thing. And it's a field, you can fill in abstract, you want this keywords. They will give you the relevant hits according to your search.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes. I believe it's informative to all.
Rakesh. Thank you. Bouquet. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Now we shall proceed further for the valedictory function. All the audience, please stay with us for the valedictory function. Honorable Dr. S. T. Patil, Vice President of Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha. A person with good communication and interpersonal skills who can work with a range of other people with full enthusiasm. Honorable Dr. S. T. Patil, sir, welcome. I invite Dr. M. V. Patil, sir, please. Welcome Dr. S. T. Patil, sir, by offering a bouquet. Vice President of Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha, Dr. S. T. Patil, is here. Thank you very much. I found that Dr. S. T. Patil, Vice President, now please give, sir, your valedictory speech.
Good evening to all.
Good evening, sir.
Myself, Dr. Sanjay Patil, Vice President of Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha, Executive Director of Maharashtra Council of Indian Medicine, Mumbai. Today, on this occasion of National Seminar on Cyber Security, Cyber Forensics, Intellectual Property Rights, I would like to show gratitude towards the eminent resource people invited by our institute, Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha. Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha is known education institute in Maharashtra. महाराष्ट्रातली एक खानदेशातली अग्रगण्य संस्था म्हणून श्री शिवाजी विद्या प्रसारक संस्था अग्रगण्य म्हणून ओळखली जाते. त्या संस्थेच्या माध्यमातून जवळजवळ 111 वर्षाचा इतिहास असलेली ही संस्था 1908 साली त्या संस्थेचं बीजारोपण झालं. तत्कालीन समाज धोरणांनी
या संस्थेचं बीजारोपण केलं.
पुढच्या काळात आमच्या ग्रुपचे आधारवड माजी मंत्री माननीय दाजीसाहेब रोहिदासजी पाटील यांच्या मार्गदर्शनाने या संस्थेचा वटवृक्ष झाला. आज KG पासून तर PG पर्यंत सर्व प्रकारच्या फॅकल्टीज या संस्थेच्या माध्यमातून शिकवल्या जातात. एक ऐतिहासिक असा वारसा या संस्थेला लाभला आहे. या संस्थेच्या माध्यमातून या खानदेशात अग्रगण्य संस्था होण्याचा मान मिळण्याचा विषय म्हणजे KG पासून PG पर्यंत, डेंटल पासून मेडिकल पर्यंत विविध प्रकारच्या शिक्षणाचा सहभाग या संस्थेमार्फत आहे. आज देखील COVID-19 जी महामारी आहे जिने जगात धुमाकूळ घातला आहे त्या माध्यमातून देखील SCPM मेडिकल कॉलेजच्या माध्यमातून जवळजवळ 800 बेडचं हॉस्पिटल आहे. त्या ठिकाणी क्वारंटाईन वॉर्ड, COVID-19 वॉर्ड, विविध प्रकारची सेवा या संस्थेच्या माध्यमातून दिली जाते. खरं या संस्थेला श्री शिवाजी संस्थेला एक उमदे व्यक्तिमत्व नेतृत्वाला लाभलंय. या धुळे ग्रामीणचे आमदार, धुळ्याची शान, तरुणाईचा ताईत, तरुणाईचं नेतृत्व माननीय बाबासाहेब कुणाल पाटील हे धुळे ग्रामीणचे आमदार आहेत आणि श्री शिवाजी विद्याप्रसारक संस्थेचे चेअरमन आहेत. त्यांच्या नेतृत्वाखाली या संस्थेची वाटचाल अतिशय यशस्वीप्रमाणे शैक्षणिक, सामाजिक, सांस्कृतिक आणि विविध क्षेत्रामध्ये घोडदौड करत आहे. त्यांच्या या कामामुळे त्यांना जलदूत आमदार म्हणून ओळखलं जातं. मागच्या पंचवार्षिकमध्ये एक जलसंधारणाचं मोठं काम कुणाल बाबांच्या माध्यमातून झालं. भविष्यामध्ये आता जो विषय आपल्या समोर आलेला आहे COVID-19 माध्यमातून, कारण मी वैद्यकीय क्षेत्रातला माणूस आहे मित्रांनो, तुमचे हे सगळे प्रकारचे सेमिनार्स, वेबिनार्स तुम्ही आम्ही बघतो आहोत ऑनलाईन इंटरनेटच्या माध्यमातून. हा मला वाटतं 5वा वेबिनार या सायन्स कॉलेजच्या माध्यमातून आहे. तर आमच्या या वेबिनारचे, या सेमिनारचे प्रमुख, ऑर्गनायझिंग कमिटीचे चेअरमन प्राचार्य बापूसाहेब मनोहरजी पाटील, त्यांच्यासोबत काम करणारे विरारी सर, त्याचप्रमाणे KM बोरसे सर, त्यांच्याबरोबर असलेले सगळे त्यांचे कलिग्स डॉक्टर राकेश देवरे असतील, डॉक्टर हर्षल भांबरे असतील, डॉक्टर चेतन पाटील असतील, डॉक्टर प्रवीण महाले असतील, या सर्वांच्या टीम आणि त्यांच्या माध्यमातून अतिशय चांगल्या प्रकारचे विषय घेऊन पार्टिसिपेंट जे आहेत, मग ते प्राध्यापक असतील, शिक्षकेतर असतील किंवा आम पब्लिक असेल. आता आजचे जे विषय होते आणि कालचे जे विषय होते हे तर मी असं म्हणेन की ही सर्वसामान्य लोकांसाठी असलेले विषय होते. सायबर क्राईम आणि सायबर सिक्युरिटी आणि सायबर फोरेन्सिक आपण ह्या ज्या गोष्टी बोलतो त्या फक्त कागदावरच बोलतो, पण या वेबिनारच्या माध्यमातून अतिशय सखोल असं कालच्या याच्यामध्ये डिकोस्टा आणि डॉक्टर महाजन या दोन लोकांनी अतिशय चांगल्या प्रकारे, डॉक्टर कीर्ती महाजन, डॉक्टर हॅरोल्ड डिकोस्टा यांनी या संदर्भामध्ये एक चांगलं इंटरॅक्शन काल घडून आलं. काल मला बघता नाही आलं, पण प्राचार्य एमिवाडी सरांनी सांगितलं की भविष्यामध्ये आपल्याला अजून पुन्हा अशा प्रकारचं ठेवायचं आहे आणि हॅरोल्ड डिकोस्टा सरांनी पुन्हा येण्याचं देखील कबूल केलं आहे. आजचे देखील जे स्पीकर्स आहेत, प्रवक्ते आहेत, अतिशय ज्ञानी, अतिशय अनुभव असलेले प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर बी पी इडगे असतील, डॉक्टर निरंजनजी येवले असतील, या सर्वांचं ज्ञान या तुमच्या आमच्या नवीन पिढीसाठी खूप महत्त्वाचं आहे. आणि इंटरनेट नेटच्या माध्यमातून होणाऱ्या या सगळ्या गोष्टी या समाजापुढे आल्या पाहिजेत. याच्यातले चांगल्या वाईट सगळ्या गोष्टी समाजासमोर आल्या पाहिजेत. ते सगळं करत असताना वैद्यकीय क्षेत्रात असल्या कारणास्तव थोडस COVID-19 बद्दल दोन शब्द सांगावे असं मला वाटतं. 23 मार्च ला पहिला लॉकडाऊन झाला, तर 31 मे पर्यंत जवळ 4 लॉकडाऊन झाले. 69 दिवसामध्ये लॉकडाऊन, आणि तेव्हा जी थीम होती आपली स्टे ॲट होम स्टे सेफ. आज नवीन सुरुवात झाली आहे अनलॉक 1. आजपासून खरी जबाबदारी मित्रांनो सगळ्यांची आपली वाढली. तर प्रत्येक माणसाला जीव प्यारा आहे मित्रांनो, आणि जान है तो जहान है. या माध्यमातून विचार करताना अनलॉक 1 धीरे धीरे टप्प्याने एक एक गोष्ट आता कमी होणार आहे. म्हणून पहिल्या स्लोगनचा आता काही अर्थ नाही. तुम्हाला उद्यापासून किंवा आजपासूनच फिजिकल डिस्टन्सेस, कितीही गर्दी असू द्या तरी स्वतःला सांभाळण्याचं काम आपण केलं पाहिजे. लोकांमध्ये जाताना कमीत कमी 2 मीटर 3 मीटरचं अंतर ठेवा. मास्क बांधल्याशिवाय घराबाहेर पडू नका. सॅनिटायझर कायम खिशात असू द्या. दिवसातून 5-7-8 वेळा तरी हात स्वच्छ धुतले गेलेच पाहिजे. स्वतःही धुवा, दुसऱ्यालाही धुवू द्या. आणि हा शेवटी परामर्श आहे, सगळ्यांनी पाळलं तरच या गोष्टी होणार आहे. आज मुंबईमध्ये रोज प्रचंड 2-3 हजार रुग्ण रोज कोविडचे सापडत आहेत. देशामध्ये जवळजवळ 1,90,000 आकडा आहे मित्रांनो. 23 मार्चला काय होता तुम्हाला माहिती आहे. आजचा आकडा 1,90,000 आहे, आणि त्याच्यातले जवळजवळ 5,000 मृत्यूमुखी पडले. महाराष्ट्र अव्वल आहे. मुंबई ठाणे आणि पुण्याला हॉटस्पॉट म्हणून घोषित केलेलं आहे. आपल्या जवळच मालेगाव आहे. मालेगाव देखील अडचणीचं आहे, औरंगाबाद अडचणीचं आहे. या माध्यमातून विचार करताना महाराष्ट्रात देखील जवळजवळ 67,000 कोविड पॉझिटिव्ह असताना जवळजवळ 2,300 लोकांचा मृत्यू झालाय मित्रांनो. झाल्यानंतर देखील जो रेट आहे दुरुस्तीचा, रुग्ण बरा होण्याचा रेट जो आहे, तो अलीकडे वाढत चाललाय मित्रांनो. पहिले 10% होता, नंतर 20 झाला, 21 झाला, परवापर्यंत 42 होता, आणि कालचा जर रेट बघाल तर 47% रुग्ण हे बरे होत आहेत. फक्त लपवू नका. जर समजा आजूबाजूला असेल तर त्याला त्वरित दवाखान्यात दाखल करा. एक लपवल्यावरती एकामागे 500 लोक वाढतात मित्रांनो. आणि मनापासून एक विनंती आहे आपल्याला की आपण स्वतः देखील या गोष्टी पाळा, सगळ्यांना पाळू द्या. आणि कोविडवरती आपल्याला मात करायची आहे. आणि जे आपलं आयुष्यात जे फ्री लाईफ होतं, आपण जे सुंदरपणे मोकळेपणे फिरू शकत होतो, नॉर्मल लाईफ जे होतं आपलं, त्या नॉर्मल लाईफमध्ये केव्हाही कुठे जायचे जशी आपल्याला मुभा होती, तशा प्रकारचा लाईफ सर्वांचं पुन्हा लवकरात लवकर येऊ. त्या माध्यमातून आपण सर्वांनी ते पाळावं अशी मी विनंती करतो. या सेमिनारला कुलगुरू कवयित्री बहिणाबाई चौधरी नॉर्थ महाराष्ट्र विद्यापीठाचे विद्यार्थी प्रिय कुलगुरू प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर पी पी पाटील सर हे आमचे प्रमुख आश्रयदाते आहेत. त्याचप्रमाणे डायरेक्टर ऑफ एज्युकेशन डॉक्टर धनराजजी माने हे देखील आमचे प्रमुख आश्रयदाते आहेत. काल ज्यांच्या हस्ते उद्घाटन झालं ते प्रो VC डॉक्टर प्रोफेसर माऊलीकर सर, जॉईंट डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर सतीशजी देशपांडे, रजिस्ट्रार प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर बी.व्ही. पवार, या सर्व मान्यवरांचं विद्यापीठीय कक्षेच्या माध्यमातून जे जे आपण प्रोग्राम घेतो, आमच्या संस्थेचे प्राध्यापक लोक जे घेतात, संस्थेचं जसं पाठबळ असतं तसं विद्यापीठाचं देखील पाठबळ असतं. उद्घाटनाच्या ह्याच्यात प्रो VC सांगितलंय की तुम्ही जे वेबिनार घेणार ते युट्यूबवर व्हॉट्सअपवर विविध प्रकारच्या ह्याच्यावरती तुम्ही ते डिस्प्ले करत राहा. लोकांना दाखवत राहा, याचा फायदा सर्वसामान्य लोकांना देखील व्हावा, अशा प्रकारचं उद्घोषण काल माऊलीकर सरांनी केलंय. सर्वांचा परामर्श घेताना डॉक्टर मनोहर पाटील आणि त्यांच्या सर्व टीमला मी शुभेच्छा देतो. या ठिकाणी थांबतो. जय हिंद, जय महाराष्ट्र.
थँक्यू, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच ऑनरेबल डॉक्टर एस टी पाटील, व्हाईस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ श्री शिवाजी विद्या प्रसारक संस्था. थँक्यू फॉर युअर काइंड सपोर्ट. आय फाउंड दॅट युअर टॉक वॉज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट एंगेजिंग दॅट आय हॅव युअर हॅड द प्रिव्हिलेज टू लिसन टू. थँक्यू once again honorable dr st patil sir. Since last two days we are hearing these topics, that is cyber crime, cyber. Dr kirti mazan, director international student welfare center bharati vidyapeeth pune, on the topic of cyber security offenses and defenses. Dr herald dicosta sir, president cyber security corporation, on the topic of cyber forensic. And today dr niranjan yole sir, scientist of national chemical laboratory. Professor Dr. B.B. Idge sir, scientist of National Chemical Laboratory. Anybody, any participants wants to be give his vote, please raise your hand so that we can give the spotlight on you in this valedictory function. Anybody wants to speak or gives your votes, please raise your hand so that we can give the spotlight on you. Yes sir, please.
Sir Marathe sir.
Marathe sir, Marathe sir.
Sir, I am able.
Yes sir, please carry on.
Sir, the webinar series organized by your college is very nice, and all the four resource persons use or deliver their knowledgeable information to all the participants. Tomorrow the lecture was yesterday was held by Mrs. Mahajan and Costa sir was very informative, and all the related information about the cyber crime, cyber securities, and how to keep the information confidential, which is online, which are going to online, how can we protect ourselves using the fake news from the various social apps like WhatsApp and other applications, from where we are sending our emails even though are not secure. And such a type of knowledge is reached up to the ground level by Dr. Dicosta sir, and today's information lectures by Dr. Yole sir and the Idge sir about how to fill the patents, even though this information is not general for us, and that's why it is very important for us about the patent, and from ourselves also can try for patent, our research scholars can also try for patents, even though in our areas so many such a type of research are there which are very important for the world, and anybody else can file the patents. And I congratulates all the team of Principal Dr. M. Patil sir and their team to organize such a fruitful webinar related to these critical topics. Thank you sir, thank you very much.
Thank you Dr. Marathe sir, thank you very much for your kind sharing of votes. Thank you. Anybody wants again, please raise your hand so that we can give the spotlight on you. There are the messages in the chat box. Congratulations to organization team for the successful organization. Yes. Thank you. Now, the best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or touched. They must be felt by heart. Thank you. One such a prayer among them. Now I can call Dr. Rakesh Devri sir for a vote of thanks.
Thank you sir. On behalf of Shri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Sanstas, late Karmave Dr. P.R. Ghogre, Science College Dhule, and the entire organizing committee of the national webinar on cyber security, cyber forensic, and intellectual property rights, here together extend a very hearty vote of thanks to Honorable Professor P.P. Patil, Vice Chancellor, KBC NMU Jalgaon, Honorable Professor P.P. Mahulikar, Sir, Pro Vice Chancellor, KBC NMU Jalgaon, Honorable Dr. D.V. Mane, Sir, Director, Higher Education, Maharashtra State, Honorable Dr. Satish Deshpande, Sir, Joint Director, Higher Education, Jalgaon Region, for their well wishes and enlightening us during the virtual session. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation for Honorable Babasaheb Kunalji Patil, MLA, and Chairman Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha, Dhule, for providing all necessary facilities during the organization of this webinar. And I am also thankful to Honorable Bhaiya Saheb, Dr. S.T. Patil Sir, Vice President, Sri Shivaji Vidya Prasarak Samstha, Dhule, for spending his valuable time and share his important thoughts with us. Thank you, sir. Further, we are grateful to Honorable Professor B.B. Idge Sir, Senior Scientist, NCL Pune, for delivering very wonderful informative talk on intellectual property rights. Thank you, sir. And we also grateful to Dr. Niranjan Evule Sir, Scientist, NCL Pune, for today's talk on patent filing and processing in India. I also wish to express my gratitude to our Honorable Principal Dr. M.V. Patil for providing encouragement and all necessary facilities. Last but not least, I also express my gratitude towards our conveners, Dr. Amit Biraris, Dr. K.M. Borse Sir, Dr. Herschel Bhamre. Thank you, sir. Now I like to hand over control back to K.M. Borse Sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Rakesh, for your very well vote of thanks. There is one announcement for the participants. Very shortly after this webinar, we will give a feedback form on our Telegram channel. Please fill the feedback form immediately so that we can make the certificates, and you will get the certificates within 2 days. Now it is the time for the national anthem. To show the respect and dignity towards our nation, let's sing the national anthem together. So please stand up for the national anthem.
So 1 minute only.
Within 1 minute, we will start it. Dr. Rakesh. As it take time, before that, I have one announcement. Yes, sir, please take your own time, don't.
गणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जय जनगण मंगलदायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
थैंक यू डॉक्टर राकेश You will get the certificates in 2 days. Please fill the feedback form. I will add this feedback form on our Telegram channel. Those who are not joined on the Telegram channel, please join it so that we can give certificates to everybody. You will get your certificates on your mail. Meanwhile, stay home, stay healthy. We are already operating with many of these rules in Dhule. Take a proactive approach, ensure the safety of our students and community. सुरक्षा से काम कीजिए और सुरक्षित जीवन का आनंद लीजिए थैंक